Welcome to Chemistry with Caroline. In this video, we're going to cover what information we can get from a proton NMR. The proton NMR contains much information and it allows for structural determination of molecules. So you may have nothing more than a molecular formula. So that tells you what atoms are present, but not how they're connected to one another. Using a proton NMR, we can determine a lot about the connectivity of the molecule. So I'm going to go over the basic information we get out of a proton NMR, and then in subsequent videos, I'll do a deeper treatment of each so you can determine how to use that to your advantage. So first, the proton NMR tells us about the number of unique protons on that molecule. So what I mean by that is the number of protons that are in different chemical environments. And the way that we see this borne out is through the number of signals that we observe on our proton NMR. So if I have four unique types of protons, I'll see four signals. If I have three unique types of protons, I would see three signals. A second piece of information that we can obtain from the proton NMR is the number of protons on the neighboring carbon atom. So how many protons are on the next door neighbor carbon? We can do this using the N plus one rule, and I'll go over this in more detail in a subsequent video, but essentially this has to do with splitting. And that is really just what does our signal look like? So a signal might just look like one peak. This is called a singlet. And that happens when there's no neighbors. When there's two neighbors, then you might get a peak that's split in two, and that's called a doublet. N is equal to the number of protons on the neighboring carbon. So if there's one neighbor, one plus one is two, I get a doublet. If I had two neighbors, I'd get a triplet. And that would look like this. And I could have three neighbors, and that would give me a quartet. So the multiplicity of the signal tells me a lot about the structure of the molecule. A third piece of information that I can get from the proton NMR is the amount of each type of unique proton. So say we have a type of proton, HA. We can literally integrate the area under that signal, under the peak, and determine the relative amount compared to other protons on the molecule. So this is just really the mathematical operation of integration. And like, let's say that we have a quartet somewhere on our NMR, and the computer will integrate the area under that curve, and it'll give us some number here that compares to the other numbers, and it lets us determine the relative amount of each type of proton. The last piece of information that we get from the proton NMR is the characteristics of the neighboring atom. So how electronegative it is, if it has a pi system or not, and that comes out in the chemical shift, and that is essentially where the signal appears on the spectrum. So below here, I have a chemical shift range that is typical for a proton NMR. It's measured in parts per million, and I'll go into that more on the video specific to chemical shift. But most protons will show up between a range of 0 and 10 parts per million on the proton NMR, and where exactly they show up is dependent on the characteristics of the neighboring atom. So I hope you found this video helpful. If you did, please like, subscribe, and share with your friends, and I'll see you next time.